When I find used tapes of reasonable quality at thrift shops, I tend to bring them home because I'm curious what's on them and in what state they are. I figured I'd share it with you guys because you may like this. I'm using a Denon DR-M30HX deck this time. That may change, I'm not sure. I'm not sure how many of these I'm going to do anyway. The Denon is directly hooked up to a computer for recording the output, and I'm listening through headphones, which I'm not wearing now because then I'd be screaming at you! We have a simple digital source to play from and a song that should be free of license issues. This time we have two tapes, a TDK SAX60 in a metal XR box by Sony. I think it's actually a TDK box to be honest, but they just changed the end day. And there's a TDK CD-ing, which is a Type 1 CD-ing, which is kind of weird because usually you see these in Type 2, actual Chrome. Let's start with the SAX. It's a tape I generally quite like. Not sure what's on it. We'll only play this briefly because otherwise we may get issues with whatever music is on there. That's very, very, very 80s indeed. And let's try this then. Okay, this tape was probably recorded when this was brand new because the music's spot on for the era. So probably only recorded once. I'm gonna fast forward it a little because you never know what's happened to it. I don't wanna get the worst part of the tape. And I'm going to set the recording level. So that's about plus two, which is what this tape should easily be able to take, just to try it out. Let's record. And let's switch to source. It's a bit dull sounding, let's change the biasing a bit. Ooh, dropouts. Okay, that's about all right. I'll roam the city with my head up in the clouds. So as you may be able to hear, the tape is losing some high frequencies and it has a few dropouts, but you mainly will hear those through headphones. Other than that, it seems to perform quite well. It's definitely usable. It's not in the best shape. I've heard them sound better, but I'm going to use it to probably give away for someone who's not too much into tapes. These SAs are sort of the higher, upper medium market tape of TDK. I think it's one of their more serious chrome tapes, or actually Super Evelyn, it's not technically chrome. And it's usually quite easy to bias, so I'm surprised this one doesn't sound better than it does, but it's still a really nice shell with a transparent layer over it. I'm not sure if you can see, but there's a transparent layer on everything, making it look very shiny. The other tape is the TDK CD-ing. As I said, you usually see them in chrome variety. I'm surprised to see a ferric one. That's a first for me. It's also why I took it, because I was curious what it sounds like and how it compares to, say, a TDK D. Another reason I took this one is that it's 74 minutes, which is kind of cool and sometimes useful. It already tells you what's on there, and I hope it's been erased because it's not my kind of music. Here we go. I'm afraid it's correct. Yeah. I noticed both tapes were recorded quite well, so they may have been from the same owner at some point. I just randomly found them in the pile of tapes that the thrift shop had on offer. Let's see how it records. Let's put the biasing in the middle again. It is being recognized as a ferric tape here. You can see it has a little indicator that says normal now, and now it says metal, and with the chrome tape just now it said chrome. So that's correct. Let's see. We're listening to tape now. As I'm sure we can agree on, the ferric tape actually outperforms the chrome tape. It shouldn't, but it does, and I find this happens quite often. There's nothing wrong with ferric tapes. So what we didn't do yet is listen what's on the other side of this tape, because it was all the way rewound. The sticker says New Bomb Turks, which is a weird combination with the Dutch band Van Dijkhout that was on the other side. But let's see if it's correct. Let's rewind it a bit and hope there's something at the end. Pretty sure that's The Offspring. That's probably something they added because it's also punk, as are the New Bomb Turks. So I can imagine the New Bomb Turks at the beginning of this tape. It's not really a quick winder, this Denon. It's also not been used for some time. I just grabbed it from the pile to use for this video because it's a reliable machine and it sounds good. And it's a three-head machine, which makes comparing easier. I may go to two-head machines at some point doing these videos. But this is the first one, so I figured I'd take this one because it's a machine that deserves some attention and admiration. There you go. Weird combination of music on this tape, but there you go. That is indeed, if I'm not mistaken, the New Bomb Turks. And this is... Is that still Van Dijkhout? That didn't actually sound too bad. Yep, it is. Okay, there you go. So, two tapes. One very usable, and I will definitely use this for my own recordings. And the other one, not so great, but still a good tape to have, because I like the shell. It's in good shape. It's a pity the box is not original, but then I usually use my own inlays anyway. As you can see here, I do that. And, yeah, it's definitely good enough to give away to someone who doesn't listen critically through headphones. So I'd say that's a good score for, I think I paid 25 cents for the two or something, or 35. They were added to a pile of other thrifting stuff, and they just added a random amount. So, not bad. I'll let this rewind, but I won't bother you with that. This was the first tape test video of probably a series, if you like.